So happy to see everybody here. And hello to those people watching us on, what is it?
Facebook.
Facebook! There's so many platforms these days. Facebook. So glad to have you also. So it looks like we have a special treat today. Amy Jo will be speaking today and sharing some wonderful things with us. And then we also have Doug, who will be doing the rest of the service. And we have Alicia Willinger, who is I thought his beautiful clarinet. Lovely, thank you. And our house musician, Rick Moran. Nice to see you all today. So, what's that?
It's coming on and off.
It was?
Now it sounds fine.
Now it's good? That's because I was touching the microphone. Don't touch the microphone. So if you'll please turn off your phones during the service, we'd appreciate it, or please put them on silent. Thank you. Oh, no, I'm not going away yet. Stay right where you are. Yes, we're going to sing first, actually. We are going to sing a wonderful joy song, so stand when you are able, and let's just belt it out.
Being here, and thank you for those that are on the internet listening to us maybe this week or live today. I'm going to start out with a little, it's not quite like a Bible verse, but it's sort of like a God inspiration. It occurred to me this week, you know, we have the prophets in the Bible. We have Elijah, David, Moses, certainly. We had many more. And Haggai, and then it occurs to me, we have wisdom also from like the Andy Griffith show, Mayberry. And I remember one episode where Malcolm Merriweather from England was riding through Mayberry, and he caused an auto accident. And of course, Barney ran him in. Andy had already met him. Barney ran him in, and Malcolm, I remember him saying that beautiful British accent, "Can I have a do-over? Can I have a do-over?" And it occurs to me, a lot of us would like to have a do-over in our lives, wouldn't we? You know, we've maybe done some things we regret. Maybe we missed some opportunities we probably should have taken. There was a teacher. She was a teacher to teenagers. And she wondered what they thought. And so she went to some adults. She said, "Tell me about what you would tell your younger self today." Well, surprisingly, they almost all had the same answer. They said, "Well, I would be more optimistic, and I would tell myself things generally turn out all right, and I would tell myself to have hope, and I would tell myself to be grateful." Some people even have a gratitude book, as we were talked about last week. Well, she took this information back, and she shared it with her teenagers in her classroom. And it turns out that these students Well, you know, we have Facebook and Instagram and Snapchat and all this other stuff. The students did not have the solid belief that everything is going to be okay. They did not have the belief that things are fixable. They did not have the belief that everything is lovable or they are lovable. And she was surprised at the outcome. And her words, her parting words, are, we probably should tell, whether they want to hear it or not, the younger generation, that everything is fixable, that everyone is lovable. You see, we all get a sunrise every day. And some of us are walking further on that path in life, and we can bring those that are behind us and tell them that, hey, look, the views get even better. Thank you. Now, if you would, let's go to our statement of being. This is who we are and what we're about. Please recite with me. God is all, invisible and visible, one presence, one mind, one power is all. This one that is all is perfect life, perfect love, and perfect substance. I am the individualized expression of God, and I am ever one with His perfect life, perfect love, and perfect substance.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Wonderful piece for you to play. I think it's a really beautiful piece. It's by Maurice Ravel, a French composer, often known as Debussy's counterpart. As an impressionist composer, and I'm going to be playing his Habanera, which is, you know, a Spanish dance. He was influenced by, I think, Musset, you know, Carmen. This piece was really for bass voice and piano, and it's been arranged for many different instruments. I'll be playing it without piano today, but if I were playing a piano, you would definitely hear that Habanera rhythm with here. So, bum 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 bum. But anyways, hope you enjoy.
Okay, I would like to guide you in a healing meditation. So I'm going to guide you in relaxation, and then we'll take 90 seconds after that in quiet and stillness to connect with God. So if you will, close your eyes. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. Take another deep breath in through your nose. Hold it for 2 seconds. Exhale through your mouth. Take another deep breath, inhale through your nose and hold it for 4 seconds, 4 counts. Exhale through your mouth. One more time. Inhale, hold it. And exhale. Visualize the back of your head. Visualize the middle of your head. Visualize your throat. Visualize the back of your throat. Visualize the back of your heart to your spine. Visualize the back of your belly button to your spine. Visualize your lower back. With your eyes still closed, look above you. Visualize white light flowing through the top of your head, your crown chakra. Through your head, your neck, your shoulders, down your arms, into your fingertips. Down your chest, stomach, hips, down your legs, into your feet, to your toes. Through the floor into the earth. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. And let's sit in silence for 90 seconds. Okay, take a deep breath in, hold it. Exhale through your mouth, relax your shoulders. Welcome back. Okay, you'll join with me. It's like the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who is everywhere, your name is sacred, your kingdom is come, your will is throughout the earth, even as it is throughout the universe. You give us our needful bread from day to day, and you forgive us our offenses as we forgive our offenders. But you separate us from error, because yours are the kingdom, the power, and the song of praise from all ages, throughout all ages, sealed in faith, trust, and in truth. Amen. Good morning.
Good morning.
I remember having a counseling session with Maria several years ago. I don't remember exactly what the issue was. I've had many issues. I don't know. I don't remember exactly what that particular issue was that I needed help with. But I knew I'd feel better after talking with Maria. I can visualize, I can remember how intently she listened, and she nodded in understanding. Or she would wince, you know, whatever detail I was sharing in empathy. I remember feeling understood by her. And then towards the end of our session, when I was waiting for the answer to my problem, Maria said something like, "Let's connect with God." And I thought, oh Lord, here we go again. That's her answer for everything. I was looking for details on step-by-step details on exactly what I should do to remedy this issue. Well, Maria was giving me the remedy. I just had something else in mind. It's taken me a couple of years to embrace that step of connecting with God as the step to take to answer my problems. That step has not been a quick fix for me, and I can't say I feel peace in that exact moment when I connect with God. But then I'll get busy doing something else, and a solution will come to mind. It may not be the solution I was hoping for, it may not happen as quickly as I was hoping for, but it comes and it is a solution. I have enjoyed connecting with God. A couple of years ago, I found a YouTube audio of a woman giving a guided meditation, very similar to what I just led you all with. Her meditation crescendoed to my feeling a vibration, the deepest connection to God that I've ever felt. And I got really hooked with that vibration. I would actually feel buzzed. I'd listen to that YouTube audio every day, sometimes twice a day. I really liked the connection. And miracles were happening. Miracles were happening more often. And I really felt like I found the golden key of connecting with God. And then sometime this spring, that audio on YouTube was gone. I panicked. I was like, oh my God, how am I going to connect with God now? I emailed the author 3 times. Can you please, I'll pay you whatever. Can you please, you know, send me the audio to download? And she responded. She said, I'm on vacation. You know, I'll send it to you when I return. And I haven't heard from her. It's been a real struggle for me to connect with God without that audio. I was heavily dependent on that audio. I try and I try. And I know I can connect with God on my own. Each of you all connect with God on your own. Rita tells us, just get still and connect with God. So I try every day. I know it's the step to take, and I take that step every day. So the first time I stepped into this building was around 1980-1981 when I had a piano recital. It's about ninth grade. At that time, it was just another community space where we had a piano recital. Then a couple of years later, my senior year of high school, 1982-83, I met Dr. William Hauser, who was a teacher at the newly created City School in downtown Roanoke. And how many of you remember Dr. William Bill Hauser? During one of the classes at City School that Dr. Hauser was teaching, I was the only one to answer one of his questions. And in that moment, I remember it distinctly, in that moment we had a connection and our mutual admiration and respect for each other was born. We became very good friends. When I was in college, he gave me a couple of pocket pamphlets that he had written. I just remember Divine Science on the front of the pamphlets. He autographed them, you know, put a special message in them to me. I didn't read them. I thought it was really cool that he wrote them, and I was like, okay, you know, not only is he intelligent and successful, and he's religious too, okay. I was really touched that he shared them with me, though. I remember feeling that was special. I didn't realize, I called him Doc, I didn't realize Doc's position here with the church until Morita shared how he had financially backed the building of the church. Yeah, helped to build it. And though I wasn't interested in religion at that time, those little booklets planted a seed. I still have them. So I grew up attending St. Elizabeth's Church on Grandin Road, which Nancy knows about. It was a pleasant, positive experience. I often hear people's stories about how they did not have such a pleasant experience in the church they grew up in. Mine was pleasant. It was fun. The middle school program was fun. We had Baskin Robbins ice cream, and you know, we shared our junior high problems. I don't remember what their belief was, but it was a good experience. Well, in college, I became atheist after reading books and articles about unsavory acts by religious groups throughout the ages. I just had enough. I remained proudly atheist for the next 10 years throughout my 20s, after graduating from college, moving up and working in Washington, D.C. I was working for the Air Force Association, a nonprofit, and developed a very special friendship with Sherry, who was a graphics artist. We were very, very close, closer than two sisters could be. And in 1998, Sherry took her life. So the next day after she took her life, I was sitting on her bed in her apartment, and I was just processing everything, trying to figure out what led to her taking that action, you know, what I could have done different. So I'm sitting there, and my head was full and heavy, and all of a sudden, I feel this feeling flow through me, like warm honey. Just like I guided you in the meditation from head down through your neck and shoulders, down your chest, into your legs. That's what happened. And it was slow, warm honey just filling me up. And then through the outside, my exterior, like a cocoon. And I was like, who is that? What was that? And I was like, sure, he's fine. Let's go home. And I felt such peace. And then I'm like, what was that? And that was a turning point for me. That was a life shift. You know, I knew there was a greater force. Wasn't sure what it was, how it was defined. I knew there was something else going on. So that ended my days of atheism. That was quite a gift that Sherry gave me. I wanted to understand what that warm honey feeling was. I was working at L'Enfant Plaza right near the Smithsonian Castle, and in the bottom level was a kind of shopping mall. And there was a bookstore right underneath my office building. And I would sit on the floor of that bookstore a couple of hours every day during work, reading pages from any spiritual book that jumped off the bookshelf. One that was particularly interesting to me was titled Of Water and a Spirit by Maladoma Patrice Sommet. His story was, as an African boy, he was stolen from his village and placed in a missionary camp to become a priest. He escaped from the camp at age 16 to find his roots. His journey along his way back to his family involved otherworldly experiences. Things like jumping into a fire and seeing, being buried underneath the soil and seeing like neon lights connecting him with spirit. Maladoma Patrice Sommet was also, his experience was so profound, he was able to easily remember what he read in his textbooks and easily earned his PhD. Well, I thought that was pretty cool. I was intrigued by the greater force in his life. I kept reading different pages from different spiritual books. I was really thirsty. A couple of years later, my ex-husband and I were sitting in a therapist's office. She asked, do you two attend church? And shook our heads, no. We later separated, and I felt devastated about the ending of our marriage. And I thought about the therapist question. I remembered my sister had attended Unity of Roanoke when I was a little girl. So I looked for a Unity in Washington, D.C., and I found one. I liked it a lot. I enjoyed the messages there. Kendrick, my son, was baptized there. It was a nice home. There was a speaker, Reverend Jim Webb, Tacoma Metaphysical Chapel in Tacoma, Maryland. He spoke there, and I felt a connection with him, so I started attending the Tacoma Park Metaphysical Chapel. And started taking classes, and so my spiritual understanding, you know, was on a roll, had momentum. And I also attended the Arlington Metaphysical Chapel and met Dr. Reed Brown. it was an exciting time for me. I was hesitant to call myself Christian. I felt like I was a hybrid, you know, putting together all kinds of information, not really fitting into a box. I'd come home to visit my parents in Roanoke, and I'd alternate between attending Unity of Roanoke and coming to Valley Community Church. Both fed my soul, they still feed my soul. And I'd often wait until Sunday morning to decide which one I felt drawn to, and I still do. When I moved back to Roanoke in 2010, the messages I heard from Marita and Velma and guest speakers and the love I felt from you all made Valley Community Church feel like home. Julie, my sister, passed soon after I moved back home, and Dad passed a couple of months after my sister. Marita and Velma spent hours and hours interviewing me when both Julie and my dad passed. And the interview was to get, you know, a sense of what they were like and how our relationships were. And Marita and Velma delivered, you know, beautiful stories and beautiful eulogy for each of them. So at that time, another spiritual shift happened for me. So after the dust settled, after my dad died, I felt abandoned and alone because my immediate family was gone. I thought, now what? There's nobody left. Yes, I had Kendrick, my son, but in terms of immediate family support that I had known for years, that was gone. And then I heard, God, you've got God. It was an aha moment that God was what was left. And in that moment, I felt a special kinship with God. And I felt God was my new family member. It took many years for me to recover from losing my family members back to back. In my recovery, I'd often forget about my new relative, God. And then I remember. I find it interesting that it took the deaths, the removal of people I loved dearly, to strip me down to be vulnerable and open enough to receive God. I believe I can feel a strong attachment with God in moments other than when my loved ones passed over. I take time every day to connect with God. It's an evolving process. Sometimes I feel the connection strongly. Sometimes not so much at all. I enjoy listening to Doug's messages, to Nancy's messages, to Pam's messages. Always the answer is connect with God. And that's why I keep coming back to Valley Community Church, to be reminded to connect with God, to feel the love of God. And I feel the love from each of you. I feel accepted by you. I love the birthday cards, the Christmas cards. I'm grateful to each of you. And I'm grateful for Marita reminding us last week to be grateful. I'd like to end, this is short today. I'd like to end with a quote from Maladoma Patrice Sommé. The author of the From the Water and Spirit book that I mentioned earlier. It is possible that we've been brought together at this time because we have profound truths to teach each other. And that's what we do here. We teach each other love, and we teach each other to connect with God, and we're connecting with God when we connect with each other. So I'm very grateful to you. And that's the story I'm sharing today. I'm sticking to it. Okay.
The last piece I brought to play for you today is by a composer that I actually played for you a few weeks ago, Béla Kovács, the Hungarian composer who wrote the homage for Bach. And this was another tribute piece to an Israeli clarinetist by the name of Yorah Feigen. And he's an amazing klezmer clarinet player. He played in the Israel Phil for maybe 20 years, but I always love playing this piece, so I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
beautiful story, and thank you so much. Thank you. I couldn't have hit one of those notes. I was thinking about if I sang with him, what that would sound like. Would you please recite with me the blessing of the gifts? This is the time we get to give back now. Our time, our talents, as well as our funds to keep the church open so that we can all travel down this beautiful path that Amy Jo has pointed out to us. Please recite with me. Today, I acknowledge God, the present, as the source of all good, as the source of my good. With this acknowledgement, I accept His will, which is abundance in every aspect of my life. I release all thoughts of lack and limitation, and I am open and receptive to the increased flow of abundance to me. I joyfully accept the gifts of life and give freely of the special gift that I am. Through me,
God omnipresent blesses and multiplies this gift. Thank you, dear God.
Jan, some messages for us.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It's always a pleasure to hear stories. Thank you, Amy Jo, for sharing very much. Amy Jo for quite a while, probably not as long as some of you, but it's been just a joy to see her blossom and be here for the times when she's had going through struggles, as we all do, and so she's been here for us to also. So we're very grateful to have you here. So thank you for sharing. The flowers today, I think, were sponsored by Amy Jo, so they're very beautiful, so thank you for doing that. Make the announcement short. Usually we have birthday Sunday, first of the month, and we usually don't have very many birthday people here, but this month, the birthday people happen to be here. Today's Wendy's birthday, yesterday was Janet's birthday, so let's sing happy birthday to them. We'll have that. I'm not sure what we're doing for craft night. Pam's out of town, and so I'll get with Ann and see if we want to do it or not. So, and Rebecca, I don't know what she's doing, so we'll figure it out. I'll let people know if we're going to have craft night. You wanted to make an announcement, correct?
I did. As many of you know, my son-in-law, in a really awful accident at our house, passed away on April the 8th. And there was a very lovely funeral service up in Sterling at the church, the eulogy church that my daughter goes to. However, she wanted to have another memorial service here. And so that is going to be taking place on this coming Saturday, 11 a.m. And there will be his remains will be interred in our columbaria, and there will be some refreshments afterwards for anyone who would like to come. We'd be very happy to see you. Our family is going to be here, of course. And he was a very special person, and he came here every time they came to Roanoke. And we'd welcome your attendance and your support, especially to my daughter, whose life was so abruptly and painfully changed at that time in April. So thank you for that.
It's going to be 11 o'clock. Will it be inside?
The service will be inside, but maybe afterwards there'll be a short internal service afterwards, and then refreshments.
Anything else? You got anything else? All right, I don't think I have anything else short and sweet today, so that's the way we like it. Anyhow, thank you for your beautiful music. I'll tell you, there's no way I could blow that long. Good gracious. So it is just beautiful music, so thank you for that. And thank you for helping out today. I appreciate it.
This is our time where we've been ramping up our services without a benediction, but really praying for the world. So many hot spots and so forth. And you can see them. We've been looking at the same ones on the TV screen. And of course, more have been added. Please say the prayer of protection. This is, and please recite with me. The light of God surrounds you. The love of God enfolds you.
The power of God protects you. The presence of God watches over you.
The mind of God guides you. The power of God abides in you. The strength of God renews you.
Wherever you are, God is, and
all is well. Lord, we'll close. At the end of the service, if you would come by, we'll just take a few these little scraps of paper, but they mean so much to have our prayers with these scraps of paper. Now let's take just a moment. We'll take 30, 60 seconds and pray for our country, beginning now. As Amy Jo said, God is our God. God is love. Thank each of you for being here today. God bless you.
Okay, we're going to sing another song. Yay! don't look so shell-shocked. Come on, people. We're going to be excited. Stand up. We're going to sing. This is a brand new one. So if you can, listen to, Rick's notes on the piano, and I will attempt to sing this along, so please join me.
Thank you.
us together. Leave us together. Oneness and
good first attempt.